going to be the yield. This represents probably close to 10 to 12 plants worth of flower material. So this flower, being entirely dry and devoid of moisture, is going to be run through a shredder until it's a homogeneous, what we call feedstock.
Put it in there, and it takes a few seconds. Ten seconds, exactly. This is like a large coffee grinder. So we'll put it here for a few seconds, shred it up, and then Dalton's gonna show you all what we do then with that.
Yeah. This is where cultivation ends, and then our laboratory begins. So we'll go down the hallway back the way that we came and head into our lab, and I'll talk to you about how we actually get to the medicinal side of everything from the plant. Extraction, refinement, processing, and manufacturing space here in compassionate cultivation. A lot of different ways to extract cannabis and actually pull out the isolate or the distillate or the crude oil from that material. You can use things like pentane, you can use things like butane. Well, CO2 is the safest and most solventless way to be able to mechanically extract that crude oil from the feedstock materials. So next step in refinement is ethanol solubilization. So that's the second solubilization event past CO2 that we use. Once we have what we call an API, or the active pharmaceutical ingredient, which is those concentrated cannabinoids, then we're looking at what's the method of administration for manufacturing that best benefits the patient from a medical standpoint. This is my favorite place in the building. This is where we can really produce the empirical scientific data to back up our claims past the anecdotal. Right here, just kind of moving clockwise around the room, we have our GCMS, or gas chromatography mass spectrometer. So with this machine, we can take any sample of either the tincture, the lozenge, or the spray. We put it through here and we're able to check for residual solvents and residual pesticides. So like we mentioned earlier in the tour, the only solvents we use are CO2 and ethanol, which are relatively safe, but we still check for any presence of something like ethanol. And then we are pesticide free, but we don't control the inputs that come in here, like our soil and our synthetic fertilizers and everything. So we still need to check that end product for any presence of pesticides. Behind me is probably the most important machine in the entire building. It's our HPLC, or high performance liquid chromatography. So with this machine right here, I can bring a sample of flower in from one of the flowering rooms. Within 24 hours, I know to three decimal places exactly how much CBD, exactly how much THC, any other cannabinoid that we have a standard on hand for, I can get that data in my hand. Behind you is our ICPE, or ductively coupled plasma. So this is the Star Trek machine of the building. If this were on and you were to look through there, you would see it, what looks like a candle flame. It's around 10,000 Kelvin, or around the temperature of the surface of the sun. So that'll take that tincture, shoot through it, and it'll atomize the molecules and break them down into their individual atoms. With this machine, we're looking for the big four bad metals: arsenic, cadmium, mercury, and lead. The reason we're looking for those, because those are the most present harmful metals that are found in cannabis material, and they're also very harmful to people to ingest. You know, before the expansion of the program in 2019, we were purely based on intractable epilepsy with a 20-to-1 formulation, and mostly with pediatric patients at that time. So that's why you see mostly children represented here, who are our earliest adopters of the medicine. Since the expansion and our ability to serve more conditions with various ratios, and we kind of run the gamut as far as our demographics of who we serve.
Hi there. So my name is Terri Hendrix, and I just took a tour, I am blown away by what I saw and the professionals that I'm in. How things were explained to me, from how the plants start to their journey to become medicine, and the absolute compliance with making sure that every batch has the same. Has the same dose, which was really important to me. I think it's called the COA. So I thought that was just reaffirmed my belief of what a special facility this is. Super excited to be taking there the tincture.